Welcome. Well, I hope that by the end of my presentation that I've motivated you, maybe I've inspired you, and at the very least, I hope that I move you. This is my title. So it can't be done? Oh yeah? Just watch me. 16 years ago, I was a stay-at-home mom of four kids. I had done just about anything as a part-time job. I worked at Olive Garden on the weekends. I dabbled in daycare. I had my own cake decorating business, and I drove a school bus for 9 years. 16 years ago is when my oldest, Adam, he was 5 years old. Yes, I had four children by the time my oldest was five. He entered kindergarten. What an exciting time. So for me, remembering those moments, and I still see the picture, the brand new haircut, the Thomas the backpack, Thomas the Train backpack, his Winnie the Pooh lunchbox. It was such an exciting time. Adam is going to school. I couldn't believe he was old enough. 16 years ago, I had the opportunity to be a substitute teacher. And I thought, well, that's great. My husband can work another shift. He can work a little later. And I can go in and be in the school system. That's when life became interesting. It was the very first time I ever saw my son in an academic setting. To see him with kids that were his age in school. We'd been in baseball and soccer and you name it, Boy Scouts, Cub Scouts, we did all that. So I remember going to the teacher and I said, you know, I have a question for you. Is it unusual that my son can do multiplication, double digit, whatever? I said, he can read anything. And as a matter of fact, I have a research paper he wrote at home on the solar system. I said, is that unusual? Oh, Mrs. Hosey, he's fine. Adam does not give us any problems in school. He is a happy boy. All right. So I went home and I was thinking to myself, boy, I don't know, that just doesn't seem right. So that was when I began my journey of educating myself on gifted children and education. Much to my surprise is when I learned that gifted education is not federally mandated. It is not state required. There are some states in the United States that offer it. You only have a handful of universities that offer any kind of degree, and teachers aren't trained. So it was a very eye-opening experience for me, and it evolved a passion. Let's go ahead 2.5 years. Adam's halfway through second grade, and we, my husband and I, are in the child psychologist's office because my boy is having a breakdown. He has cried every day about, Mama, why do I go to school? Mama, I'm bored. I just want to stay home with you. Then came the profound moment. Adam walked in my door one day, and from the moment he walked in, 3:30 in the afternoon, he started crying. 6 hours later, he was still on my bed, and at that point, I was crying. And I said, son, I don't know what to do to help you. I had tried everything to console him. What happened? That day at school, Adam had a great sense of humor, still does, put his coat and his boots on backwards. He was going to be funny. Well, in the eyes of the teacher, no, we don't do that. That's a rule you just broke. So my son spent recess against the wall, and he was in trouble. So when he walked in my house, he thinks differently. So my boy is crying. And I'm like, gosh, I'm trying to help him through all this. And through my tears, I said, son, I don't know what to do. And he said, Mama, don't you get it? Don't you get it? I didn't know what I did was wrong. And if I didn't know that was wrong, how am I supposed to know when I do something else? And I'm going to get in trouble. He He took it so global, and I said, "Son, I don't know. I don't know how to help you, but I promise you I'm going to work on it." So I had an idea. If you read this quote, "There is one thing stronger than all of the armies in the world, and that is an idea whose time had come." And I thought about it, and I thought, "Hello, Tracy, what are you thinking? Your son is sitting in school, and he's not engaged, and he's not excited, and he doesn't even know why he goes. How many children are sitting in seats experiencing the same thing? I have no idea how I'm going to do it, but I'm going to make a difference." So my idea was to change the face of education. Education, think about it. In our minds, why do we go to school? Well, education is meant to take us into a future that we cannot see. Did you know, interesting fact, that in 2010, the top 10 jobs did not exist in 2004? Did you know that we are currently preparing students for jobs that don't yet exist, to use technologies that we have not yet invented, and to solve problems that we have not yet encountered? And according to the U.S. Department of Labor, today's learners, my son, my other three children, will have 10 to 14 jobs, they're estimating, by the age of 38. So I ask you, how do we educate in a world that is changing so fast? My answer? Cultivate a society of thinkers. It's not always about following the rule. Do we want a world of problem solvers, or do we want a world of compliant children? What or who does our society celebrate? We've got our athletes, we've got our entertainers, but I got some news for you. There's a lot of kids that are out there involved in a lot of different sports, and I'm not saying that's bad. I think it's outstanding. But when you think about a future, there's not very many kids that make it into the NFL. And there's not very many kids that make it on the NBA. And there's not very many Britney Spears. Whew, thank goodness. So what we need to celebrate. We need innovation. We need ideas. We need excellence. How? We need a varsity sport of the mind. And we need to celebrate that as a society. So a couple years ago, I'm working, I've moved my way through my school district, and I really am making a difference. Someone comes up to me and says, hey, Tracy, have you heard about this robotics competition? I'm like, no, tell me more about it. It's an organization called US First. US First was founded by Dean Kamen. He's an awesome innovator and an inventor. He invented the Segway, for those of you that might not know. So Dean sets up this organization, and I research its values, its philosophies, and I'm blown away. Two things stood out to me more than anything in the world. Number one, cooperation. Cooperation, it's a word that they coined. It's a combination of cooperation and competition. In this sport, groups of kids get together from all over the world, actually, and they compete at regional competitions. Let's say you get there with your robot that you have built and something's not working. You are expected as a member of US First that if you have the part that they need, you take it to them. And not only do you take it to them, you help them fix it. One of my boys who's backstage here helped to program a robot that somebody wasn't having success with. One of my mentors got together and helped build a robot that on the day of competition arrived in a crate. Outstanding. The next cool thing is they have something called gracious professionalism. It is all about being gracious in the face of competition. Very important life skills. So I thought, this is amazing. And I go to my school district, and they're kind of used to this by now. And I said, hey, I got this great idea. I want to start a robotics competition team. Now, I got to tell you, I got a degree in criminal justice, I have a degree in public affairs, and I have a master's in education. Nowhere in there do I have anything that talks about technology and robotics. I don't care. I'll figure it out. Go to my school district, they're like, Tracey, go ahead. Go ahead. You figure it out. You figure out how to run it, fund it, and get the kids for it. I said, you betcha, I'll do it. So, I want you to know that FIRST is not just about the robots. Very important. That's just one of the byproducts. FIRST is about focusing, not on the problem, but on the solution, creating, building, finding solutions, building self-confidence, serious relationships with adults. I can tell you, I have grown so much from these kids. They are outstanding. And it's about understanding anything is possible. It's not about the right answer. I don't know what the right answer is. Here we go. Foximus Prime, my pride and joy. I ran a couple of parent nights, a couple of student information nights. I had nothing to offer to people other than the possibility of an idea. That was it. I got this idea. I need people to come with me. So after running this kind of a thing and having these meetings, I ended up with 18 kids and 5 adults that joined me on this venture. Now, let me give you a little thing about how this works. January 8th, 2011, we go down to IIT, a very, very cold day, into Chicago, my 18 kids and my 5 adults. We go for kickoff. What that means is nationwide at the same time, actually worldwide, the competition is announced. You have no idea what you're supposed to do. You have no idea on the task of the robot. Everyone learns at the exact same time what we have to do. We have 6 weeks to build, design, program, and create this robot for competition. Everyone has the same time frame. Imagination is yours. Whatever you create is yours. So, you can see here, this is me and the kids, and they're coming for IIT. This is our kit of parts. We walked out with 2 great big Rubbermaid totes, a netbook computer, a ton of nuts, bolts, screws, trains, some Jaguar motors, wheels. Wow, all right. Put it all into those little boxes that you see right there, and we began to design and talk and build. Not one of us knew what we were doing. So if you look at that, we worked tirelessly, probably about 4 hours for 3 to 4 nights a week, sometimes 5. And that's our finished product. That's our Foximus Prime. So we competed at UIC Pavilion on the 26th of March. We finished 26 out of 52. And here's the exciting part. October 15th of this year, we had our first team meeting. All the kids could come along, bring your new recruits. I had 64 kids fill my classroom. They were everywhere. So I have a movie for you. Come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand. Close your eyes. If you really want it, got a jet pack with your name on it. Above the clouds in the atmosphere, just say the words and we out of here. Hold my hand if you're feeling scared. We're flying up, up out of here. Here we go.
your G6. Chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kick. Girl, you always on my mind. Got my head up in the sky and I'm never looking down. Feeling priceless, yeah. Where we at, only few have known. Want some next level Super Mario. I hope this works out, cardio. Till then, let's fly, Geronimo.
Here we go.
But I ain't never seen a face like yours. You made me feel like I could touch the planets. You want the moon, girl, watch me grab it. See, I ain't never seen a star this close. You got me stuck by the way you glow. I'm like, oh, 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 oh. I'm like, oh, 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 oh.
Here we go.
Thank you.